after our 1 hour journey, we reach the listeners in Western Europe and Japan. With more to be heard on the internet at www.ionizerpulse.org. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and other social media platforms. We're also available on TuneIn and via satellite Eurosat 60 and
Johannes reiterates Romania's strong support for the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Ukraine, and its right to fully decide its own European and Euro-Atlantic aspirations. A NATO battle group is to be sent up in Romania this spring, says Romania's Defense Minister Vasile Dinkić. The National Strategy and Forecast Committee revises Romania's economic growth forecast down to 4.3%. And the Romanian tennis player Simona Halep qualified for the semi-finals of the WTA 500 tournament from Dubai. And Council President Klaus Johannes attended an informal European Council meeting in Brussels. He reiterated Romania's strong support for Ukraine's sovereignty and territorial integrity, and for the country's right to decide freely on its European and Euro-Atlantic aspirations. We have to continue the dialogue and look for a diplomatic solution, Johannes also wrote on Twitter, adding that the threat to European security is still critical. The United States is also attending the 6th European-African Union Summit, focusing on granting an ambitious Africa-Europe investment package against the background of the current global challenges. President Johannes has stated that Romania wants to strengthen its traditional ties with the African state and its role as donor of assistance for development, in particular in the educational field. An actual battle group is to be set up in Romania most likely this spring, that the Defense Minister Vasile Dinkić has announced. He explained that there are still so many matters that need to be taken care of, but Romania has completed the preparation and the preparation for the final decision. Dinkić attended the meeting of the NATO Defense Ministers in Brussels, in the context of the crisis created by Russia in Ukraine's borders. The NATO Secretary General has stated that he mentioned in a press conference in relation to set up a permanent battle group in Romania. Our military commanders will now work on the details and report started in this, stating that said. On the sidelines of the meeting, the Romanian minister spoke with his counterparts from Turkey and Norway, especially about the post security situation in the Black region. He said the importance of maintaining unity and cohesion at the allied levels and considering efforts to enhance the tariffs and defense on the Eastern Front. The number of new cases of COVID-19 is dropping in Romania, so the number of related fatalities remains high, according to partial data made public by authorities on Thursday. 15,374 new cases of infected people and 125 deaths were reported, of which three from the previous reporting time frame. 1,120 patients are in intensive care. The vaccination pace has also kept slowing down, with some 7,700 people getting vaccinated on Friday, and some a little over 1,200 with the first dose. The National Vaccination Committee has announced. The National Strategy and Forecast Commission revised Romania's economic growth forecast for this year down to 4.3% from 4.6%, which previously estimated, given the inflationary shock of the last quarter of last year and the fifth wave of the coronavirus pandemic. The institution also points out that it did not take into account the possible outbreak of a conflict caused by geopolitical tensions at the border with Ukraine. At the same time, the prospects for the 2022 agricultural year are not very bright, as the year starts with drought and with very high prices for fertilizers and energy. The Romanian currency newspaper has said, after the Romanian economy registered a 5.6% growth. received from over 234 million euros from the European Commission for the operational program human capital. So far, they have 160,000 disadvantaged pupils to make up the lost lifetime during the pandemic. All the funds in the fund will support the employment of people who lost their jobs during the pandemic, as well as 295 new welfare enterprises for people in vulnerable groups. The funding will also ensure the provision of bonuses for 97,000 health workers who don't directly with the pandemic. From sports, the Romanian tennis player Simona Halep has qualified for the semi-finals of the WTA 500 tournament in Dubai. It's from $800,000 inside money. She defeated on Thursday the Canadian Santander in her first 6-2-6-5. Simona has won this tournament 2 times before, in 2015 and 2020. That was the news from Bucharest, Radio Romania International.
It includes the mission for strategy and performance.
To 4.3%. This is Daniel Group of the microphone with a report by Children at Christmas.
The National Commission for Strategy and Progress in Brooklyn.
Growth forecast 0.3%. 0.3% down
as compared to the previous action.
The forecast is mainly based on the current inflation rate, 0.8%, and expected to hit 2-digit figures shortly.
It also takes into account
the fifth wave of the coronavirus pandemic and the energy crisis.
This is what the financial forecast has explained for all the estimates
to be done.
We don't take into account the potential profit for a citation at the border with Ukraine.
The 4.3% growth has been down in keeping with the higher energy prices, which may hamper activities, especially in the chemical and steel industry, known to be major energy consumers. The functional supply chains, which contribute to price hikes of the market, are believed to continue.
Although costs by commodities are diminished,
they will continue to affect the car and electric equipment manufacturer.
Services are expected to register a low increase, especially in the household sector.
Construction is going to see a more significant development than estimated in autumn.
Growth in the sector is expected to comfortable
against the same period last year, when activities slowed down, but also because of an increased emphasis given by the incoming European funds.
The Commission is also forecast lower growth in private consumption and investment against the previous estimates.
Research has also been made on the impact of the energy price hikes and inflation rates, which translates into higher consumer prices. This increase is to be felt less in February, thanks to the new regulations aimed at capping these prices, but is to gain momentum in April. Slight increases are also expected in July and at the beginning of the cold season.
Estimates point to an inflation rate of 9.5% at the end of the year, within the annual average of 9.9%.
The estimates don't take into account other protection measures for the population base.
Such as measures are to be quantified in the listings for the forecast.
According to the government on Tuesday by the National Institute for Statistics, Romania saw a 5.6% economic growth last year, whereas its GDP dropped 0.5% in the last quarter of 2021, as compared to the previous quarter, but the rate to 2.2% against the same period of 2020.